Hello, my name is Dr. Cheryl Lentz. I'm known as the academic entrepreneur, and I'm thrilled to be part of your program to be able to talk to you a little bit about empowerment and reinvention. Success is where opportunity and preparedness meet. And many of us look at the idea of what we do to prepare ourselves, whether it's credentials, whether it's an undergrad, a master's, a doctorate, a certification, some way of being able to learn skills to be able to do what we want to do in life. But let me offer you a few questions to consider. First and foremost, why do you think we only get one? When people grow up, when you're in school, right, and you're in high school, in college, everybody's like, well, what do you want to be when you grow up? And we usually will pick one thing. And for those of you who know what your one thing is, congratulations. I know friends of mine who are doctors and lawyers and all kinds of amazing professions, but they knew from almost the moment they were 5 years old. I became a military wife for 23 years and I've moved 38 times. And because of that, I had the opportunity to choose many careers. Initially, it was a little bit challenging because I would move every 2 to 3 years and had to reinvent the wheel. But I've had such an amazing career because of the ability to reinvent myself. And that's where the preparedness part meets. As in these difficult times, I want you to think about, what do you have? What can you do? Because I know for many, the new normal has really disrupted businesses, families, lives, and all the things we used to do. That doesn't mean life stops you. That just gives you an ability to go, huh, let's find a different direction forward. Let's find something else that we might have. And I like to call this the Uber effect. Uber was a concept of being able to not have the ability to build a new car system. They used the capacity of what we already had. The founders of Uber were the ability to say, here's what people have in their own world. They already have a car, they already have insurance, all that stuff, and now we're just going to use that extra, what we call capacity. Airbnb did the same thing. And the ability, so everybody's got that guest room in their house. Everybody has the ability of one or two extra rooms and things of being able to not have to reinvent the wheel and not build something new, but use what we already have for capacity. So I want to be able to look at the opportunity of attitude in approaching that idea of capacity of what we already have, instead of looking at the glasses half empty, what we can't do, or looking at the glasses half full, what we might be able to do. Let me teach you how to choose to fill your own glass. And this is what the opportunity we have in front of us is. We have a new normal, and often crisis is what propels us to do things that we might not have done otherwise, because it's going to propel us forward in ways we wouldn't have imagined. Many people, unless there's crisis, we're not going to change. And that's the whole process of change management. So I'm not asking you for a kidney. I'm not asking you to solve world hunger. What I'm asking you to do is think about something that you could do during this difficult time. My solution was, if you're going to send people home and we have to be socially distanced, it doesn't mean isolation. It means the ability of, what can you do during this time? You can clean your house, you can organize, you can shred, you can look at the taxes, you can make a list of all the things that you wanted to do and you never had the time and now you do. But let's think of it a little bit differently. Is what else could you do to still take care of yourself when it comes to a career? If you have to reinvent yourself, maybe we need to look at those who've already done it, because here's the secret to reinvention. Don't reinvent the wheel. Find someone who has done what you want to do and either hire them or ask them if they will coach you to do and follow in their footsteps, right? So much easier to follow what, find what successful people have done and just follow in our footsteps. It's a little bit scary because remember, we were all one day where you are, and now we've been able to do all kinds of interesting things because of one little word, action. And that's what I want to be able to do this. So I'm going to give you a couple of tips that you might think about. First of all, watch the people around you. Look at the Uber effect. Look at what you have in your purview right now. I go to a business conference once a year and they said 80% of everything you need is within your fingertips. Look at your Rolodex. Rolodex, you can tell how old I am. Look at your cell phone. Look at your contacts. Look at the things that are available. And you can use a concept called informational interviewing. Go talk to somebody who's got a cool job. Even in difficult times, you can do it via Zoom. You can do it over phone. Find out what they did. Research them. Go look at the LinkedIn profile. Go look at the things that they've done. Could you do that as well? If they've done it, that means you can do it. It's amazing because we don't know things can't be done until someone does them. So be the one that does them. You want to be able to look at what's called experience by proxy. That means that we don't have to have all the answers. When I teach my students, I'm a college professor, have been for 20 years. I also own my own business for the last 13. Actually, I own two. And the idea is to look at how we go forward with experience. I don't have to have all the answers. I just have to look at finding those who do. So find somebody. If you want to be able to look at doing a new business. Matter of fact, a colleague of mine told me, with Dr. Julie's matter of fact, of looking at the audiobook world. There's a lot of technology, and I'm a book publisher in there, and we're getting into audiobooks and we're getting into children's books. You can actually be a voiceover, and to be able to things you can do from your house with a little bit of creativity and making an audio studio, become the voice. If you have a voice for radio and a voice for announcing and things, put that to good use. Look at the things that you could do that you already have. You already have a computer. There's all kinds of free programs that are out there. Learn to reinvent yourself. Learn to learn from the experience of others. And finally, I want to close today with looking at the idea of trial and error. Many of the times we're afraid of reinventing ourselves because of several things. What will people say? Unless they pay my bills, they don't get a vote, is the way I look at it. We want to have the ability is I'm here to be able to look at what I can do and make in contribution to the world. And so I look at what I'm doing during this difficult time. I'm teaching many more classes because I have that experience and I have had for 20 years. I'm reading books. I'm doing all of these videos to share my experience with others. I'm learning a foreign language. I'm taking a class myself. And it's all about preparing myself whatever that next step might be. And this is the part where opportunity is going to knock. And there are opportunities all around us, believe it or not, every single day. The entrepreneur's spirit is alive and well, and form follows function. The best advice I was ever given is find a problem and fix it. You don't have to solve world hunger. You just have to do something that's going to be of value to someone else. So if you have a problem, maybe someone else does. Maybe you have a talent to fix it. Look at what you can do. I guarantee you there's lots of skills that you have, and you can watch what other people will do. It's a good time to explore, reinvent yourself, and here's the last part, have fun. Life is too short to be able to have all of this fear inside. And I know we're fear of failure. That's a big one. And I have other videos on that, so you can watch my fail faster, succeed sooner. But don't be afraid to try. Don't be afraid to fail. If you don't do well and you don't like it, do something else. That was the brilliance of internships a long time ago. As I remember one in particular that, thank goodness I only spent 6 weeks because it was something I decided going, oh no, 6 weeks was 6 weeks too long. But we have to try and we won't know until we do. And often, here's a caveat, we often learn what we don't want first, and that's still valuable. So let me offer just the final pieces of advice. Enjoy this exploration time. It's personal reflection. It's personal exploration to find out maybe there's something new. You know that book you always wanted to write? That novel, that screenplay? Whatever it is, give yourself permission to do a little exploring. We have a little time, and the world is in desperate need for leaders like you. And there's something that you're going to offer to the world, and we're waiting for you to do it, and only you can do it. So be well, be happy, be safe, and go conquer the world, because we're waiting for you. I'm Dr. Cheryl Lentz. It's been a pleasure. If there's anything I can do, look me up on the internet, drcheryllentz@gmail.com. I'm here, and I'm ready to help. Take good care. Be well. Bye.